Hi, this is Rob with Gold Plating Services, and today we're going to be showing you how easy it is to set up our new ProLab component modular system. We're going to first show you how to set up one of the modules, and then eventually we'll show you how the whole system completely sets up from beginning to end. Before we set up the module, we're going to show you each of the individual parts that come with each component module. You have a plating rack, and each of your parts hang on one of these parts here, and this will hang from the bus bar. The bus bar is going to hook up to the power tower, and each of these sets on to the base there, and eventually the beaker is added. This particular one is a heated beaker for solutions that need heating. This here is your temperature sensor. And inside of here, we have this really awesome anode frame that has screws here where you're able to attach and swap out different anodes for different solutions. For example, if you had copper and you need a copper anode, you can just undo this screw and put your copper anode in that place. It also has these handy holes right here where you can run your air tube down in for those solutions that need to have air agitation. We have a power cable and a cap for when you're finished for the day, so you can cover up your beaker and not get any debris or any evaporation. And finally, a rinse beaker. Now we're going to move over into setting up the module. All the modules are the same. The only thing that varies is the solution and the anodes, or if it needs heat, it can be either a heated or unheated beaker. So we're going to get right to setting up this module here. The power tower is first attached to the base. So we undo the screw and place it on top of the base here. The screw is then inserted into the hole that's in the bottom there. And that just kind of keeps it from wiggling around so that this tower itself can't pivot. We're doing it using this power drill. However, it can just be done with a regular screwdriver as well. It doesn't need to be a super firm insertion there. Next, you will attach the beaker by undoing that positive nut there. And the anode frame just slides right into place, which gives the positive contact for the anode frame and sends the positive electricity through the anodes. The temperature sensor then plugs in over here into the side of the power tower, and the nut is put on, which keeps it in place and makes sure that it has good contact there with that spot there. Once you have that nut secured, you next can plug in your power cord into the back. Here we have this power strip. It is nice to have access to multiple plugs, because when you have multiple stations, you're going to have multiple plugs that need to plug in. This nut comes off the side here, which is where the bus bar connects. This bus bar sends the negative electricity to complete the circuit when your rack is hung on to the bus bar. These nuts here have a hole in the front of them that also allows you to plug in a common lead wire into this spot right here. You can also put a positive here as well if you ever needed that. The rack then just hangs onto the bus bar here when you go to use it. And here we have a common lead wire for, if you wanted to, you can pivot the bus bar up out of the way, clip your common lead to the rack, and just hold it by hand as well. And that's how you set up the entire module for one individual module. And to add extras, you would do the exact same thing. So we're going to go ahead and set up another two modules and then show you how we connect them together and ultimately get the whole system set up.